which is, again, building off the remarks by my colleague, Mr. Nolan, on the importance that dams play in our communities. And, folks may not realize that we have 84,000 dams in this country. The average age of the dam is 52 years old, I'm told. In my district, there are 100 high-hazard dams. These are dams that, if failure occurred, would result in lost life or significant property damage. There is a program called the National Dam Safety Program that provides a little bit of federal money to make sure that, in a classic stitching time saves nine way, we are performing inspections at an adequate rate. The local authorities and associations have the information they need, the technical expertise they need to pay for repairs that they need to do and to pay for those repairs themselves. But the federal government has historically played an important partnership role in this activity. That's why I recently introduced the Dam Safety Act that would reauthorize this program. And I just want to emphasize it here today because one of the reasons I wanted to serve on the Transportation Infrastructure Committee and on this subcommittee is that we've got a proud tradition of working in a bipartisan way. I'm happy to say that I have an original co-sponsor from the other party, from the majority party, Mr. Gibson, who also represents parts of the Hudson Valley with hundreds of high hazard dams, just like mine. And we together want to take this important step because this is not a partisan issue. This is not a Democratic or Republican issue. This is not a Senate or House issue. The Senate has been doing good work on this as well. And while I don't believe, Mr. Chairman, that we should see our role in this important piece of legislation to the other House in any way, shape, or form, I'm encouraged to see that it's moving in that side of the Congress as well. And people may not realize that this is also not just an urban issue or a rural issue, it's both. So that while most of my dams are smaller and affect smaller communities, the fact is even the city of New York depends on the dams that support the watershed and the reservoir system for the city. So this should not divide us in any way. It should not divide us across party lines.